Hey, thanks for tuning in tonight. Happy Wednesday to you. Pastor Chris here. Listen, I know there's been a lot going on. The first thing I want to do for everyone is read a portion of a letter that I have sent out and to our leaders a few days ago. But I want to get everyone on the same page, talk about a few things, and then get right into the Word. So thanks for tuning in today. It says, Pastor Debbie and I want you to know that we love, appreciate, and we and the staff are praying for you and your families. I'm letting you know the decision I made concerning the care and well-being of our church family. After consulting with qualified healthcare professionals and acting in accordance with what the governor has directed, with even more possible restrictions probable, I'm letting everyone know that beginning which was yesterday, March the 17th, the church office will be closed and all church-related services and events, both here and away from here, will be canceled until March 30th. And I'm also asking that during that time that no one use the facility for any reasons. Now, I'm saying this and reading this and letting everyone know because we want you well, spirit, soul, and body. And so this is why we're coming alive to you, so to speak, or doing these videos so that you can understand that we care about your body, and you know that. We care about your soul, your mind, and we care about your spirit. This is why we're endeavoring to feed that. But at the same time, we're responsible to care for the whole of man. And so at this time, which is challenging to say the least, I want to encourage each of you that's a part of this congregation to reach out to one another, continue to pray for one another. And I know that this is a great inconvenience, but it is all temporary. And so some of the things I want to remind you about is just like you have tonight, go to the website and you're going to find there's Facebook chats that I do regularly anyway. You might not be familiar, or you may be familiar with them. They last usually 1 to 3 minutes. They're Mondays, and they're Wednesdays, and Fridays, and Saturdays. Amen. And then we're going to also have a regular Sunday morning and Wednesday night services. You're tuning into a Wednesday night service. And I know it's a little different, but it's going to be teaching in just one moment. We'll miss the praise and worship in the one another time. But we're going to be back together soon. And until that time, we want you to be ministered to. So make sure you keep abreast of these things. Share them with others. Make sure that if people don't know, even that are not a part of this church, let them know that there's a good word that they can hear. Because when things go crazy in the world, Jesus hasn't gone crazy, and he's here to still help us. So here we go. Tonight, Wednesday night service, I want to talk about the power of attention. The power of attention. And I'm going to ask you a question. When it comes to your attention, where is it? Where is it right now? Well, I know with everything that's going on, you know, there's certain things that we have to do. Maybe your job requires you to be watching and following the things closely. And it's nothing the matter with that to the degree that you're keeping abreast of the facts. But what we have to make sure that we do is that we still, as believers, are responding biblically or in the way that Christ would want us to respond. And so what I want us to be encouraged about tonight is to make sure that where our attention is going and headed in the right direction. So I want to read, I'll share a few scriptures with you in in Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2 and 3. It says that we're to look unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. And so what we need to understand is that we need to look to him. Our attention needs to first and foremost be turned to God, be turned to His Son, Jesus Christ, because He is the author and the perfecter, the author and the finisher. He's the source and the goal. All of those things is what that means, our faith. And so where attention is going should be to Him. Then verse 3, it says that we're to consider Him. So we're to look to Him, verse 2, and verse 3, it says that we're to consider Him. And so in other words, our attention is supposed to be on Jesus. Now, the thing that we need to understand is it doesn't supposed to be on Jesus just in the bad times. It's supposed to be on Jesus every day. But the truth is, if we learn to focus our attention on Him, no matter whether it's good times or bad times or difficult times, our attention is still the right place. And we're going to find that where attention goes, the power flows. In other words, the power from whatever we're attending to and looking to, if that whatever power or source of strength is, comes from that, either good or bad, is going to flow to our life as our attention goes to that. Also, I want us to consider Proverbs chapter 4. Proverbs chapter 4, a very familiar portion of scripture to many of you. But here's what it says in verse 20. It says, my son or my daughter, my people, it says, attend to my words. Incline your ear to my sayings. Let them not depart out of your sight. Keep them in the midst of your heart, for their life to those that find them and their medicine or health to all their flesh. And verse 23 says, keep your heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. And so notice at the verse 20, it tells us, my son, attend to my words. God says, attend to my words. So we rewind a minute and we look back at Hebrews chapter 12 and verses 2 and 3. It tells us to look unto Jesus, okay? And now in Proverbs, it says to attend to God's word. Well, Jesus is the living word. He reveals the written word. And so, in other words, what we're one portion of scripture says our attention should be on Jesus. Another portion says that it should be on the word of God. Same thing. So we get the picture here. It needs to be on Jesus. It needs to be on God's word. So we need to give our attention to. We need to fix our minds on God's word. And one way we do that is by inclining our ear to His sayings so we can listen to the word, okay? We can actually read the word and hear the word being spoken through our own lips. And it says that we let them depart from our eyes. In other words, we're to be looking at them. Amen. We're to be keeping the word before our eyes, and we're to keep them in the midst of our heart. So it's really important. If it's going to get in our heart, it's going to come this way. It's going to come through us hearing it, seeing it, saying it. That's how it gets into our hearts. And then it says, when we give it this attention and we do it this way, here's what God's word becomes to us. It becomes life to those that find them. Okay? So God's word becomes life to those that do this, that get a hold upon God's word. In other words, you push through all the distractions, you push through all the cares, and you get focused on the word of God long enough that word is speaking to you loud and clear than all the circumstances and all the situations. Until you have peace that passes all understanding, until you have some peace in your heart, you need to be looking at this, because until you do, your attention is going somewhere else, and that is stronger than the word in your life, and it will not produce in your life what it's designed to. But if we attend to the word, we incline our ear to its sayings, we let not it depart from our eyes, and we keep it in the midst of our heart, here's what happens. The word of God becomes life to us that find the word, that acquire the word, to get a hold of the word. That's what the word find means. And it says, and then it becomes health to all our flesh. So in the midst of all this going on in this world that's centered around a virus, the Bible is still saying that God's word is medicine to all our flesh. It's health. This Hebrew word means medicine. It means a medicine. It means a cure. It means healing. It means remedy. It means a deliverance. That's what this Hebrew word health means. So we're looking, man is looking for a remedy. It's looking for a cure, looking for some type of medical breakthrough. That's wonderful. We want that. We're believing for that. There's nothing the matter with that. But God says, I've already got medicine. I've already got a cure. I've already got a healing. I already got a remedy. I've already got a deliverance for those that will give attention to my word long enough that it will be produced medicine or be medicine to all their flesh. And it has everything to do with the power of attention and what we do with our attention. And then it's the last of all, it says, keep your heart with all diligence, for out of it flow the issues of life. So now, as we keep our attention is on the right thing, on the word of God, and it produces health in us, and we keep our heart, in other words, we guard our heart, we keep the wrong things out. In other words, when fear tries to come, it tries to come. When wrong words try to come, it tries to come and knocks on us. We say no, we resist it with the word of God and say, no, that's not what I believe. That might be what going around, but it's going around me, and I'm believing the word of God. And we're trusting in God. And when we keep our heart with all diligence, then it says, for out of it flow the issues of the sources of life. So what ends up happening is now we become a source of life and health and strength to others, like so many of you already are. As you're reaching out to one another, you're praying for one another, you're concerned for one another, we miss one another. But you know what? At this time, we draw into Jesus, we give him great attention, we pray. I want to encourage you to pray. Pray like never before, and God is working in ways that are mighty and that are powerful as we trust him. Now, the power of attention, let's look at one other a verse next, and that is from Philippians chapter 4, and it tells us where our attention is supposed to be going. So first of all, Hebrews chapter 12 tells us to be on Jesus. Proverbs chapter 4 tells us to be on the word, and now Philippians is going to tell us where it's supposed to go in conjunction of the things we're supposed to be thinking about. And so in Philippians chapter 4, verse 8, it says, finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just or right, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely or beautiful, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think on these things. In other words, here's what this word think on these things means. It means to focus your thoughts on, fill your mind with these things. In other words, give your attention to the right things. Okay, that doesn't mean that we can't be aware of the other things. We have to be aware of the other things around us, but they're not stronger, and we do not give our attention to them more than we are the word of God and our answer. Amen. So my question is to you tonight is simply, where is your attention? Because where your attention goes, the power flows. Now, what I mean by that is, whatever our attention on, the power of that thing that our attention on is going to flow to us. So if it's something negative, it's all worried and all fearful, then we become that, because the power of that, what do we give our attention to, the power that's in that flows to us. Okay, and so on the reverse side of that, or on the good side of that, if our attention's on Jesus, it's on the word of God and good things, then the power of that flows to us, and in our spirits, we're buoyed up in strength and in power. And so one of the things that we need to understand is, concerning our attention, what you feed the longest will be the strongest. And so that means there's things that some of you are in the medical field. And so day in and day out, you're giving your attention to the things that are concerning this virus. And you have to do that. But the truth is, what you feed the longest will be the strongest. So in the midst of all that we do, we just have to bring our thoughts and our minds back to the answer, back to the word of God, back to Jesus. Amen. And because what we feed on the longest strongest will be the strongest. I just want to encourage us that we have to keep looking to Jesus, the author, perfecter of faith. We attending to the Word of God, because what we feed the longest will be the strongest. What you feed will also grow. And so if we're feeding on the Word of God, it will grow in our lives like a beautiful garden. Amen. But if we're feeding on the negativity and we're feeding on all the negative things around, if we're feeding on that, and giving our attention to that more than we are the Word, and allowing it to be a disproportionate, being more than out of the ordinary, and that's where we trap that, then that's going to grow. The wrong thing's going to grow. But what you feed will grow. So let's make sure we're feeding our spirits on the Word of God. We're renewing our minds with the Word of God, and we're taking care of our bodies. And the good news is, since healing is really spiritual, that as you feed your spirit man, this is exactly what Proverbs 4 is saying, that the Word of God becomes medicine and health to all our flesh. Finally, the last scripture I want to share with you to show the power of attention is in Mark chapter 4, verse 24. Amplified translation says this, that says, the measure of thought and study you give to the truth you hear. What truth you're hearing? Well, it shouldn't be just the facts and the truth of the things that are in this world. God is actually talking about the truth of His Word. The measure of thought and study you give to the truth you hear will be the measure of virtue and knowledge that comes back to you, and more besides will be given to those that hear. Notice again, the measure of thought and study you give to the truth you hear. This is the truth that God wants you to hear, His Word. Will be the measure of virtue and knowledge, or power, and the power that comes from that knowledge will be given back to you, and more will be given to those that hear. That is great news. In other words, there is a multiplying effect, either for the good or for the bad, by the power of our attention. So let our attention be on the things that are pure, lovely, good report, centered around Jesus, centered around God's Word. And finally today, as we give our attention to the Word of God, we're going to find out this, that we have great peace in our heart. We're going to have strength of spirit. We have strength and health in our body. And we're going to be able to help others as well, whether we are with them, or whether we're praying for them, encouraging them by phone, email, text, however we can do that. And send people to messages like this that can give answers in times like this. And really, answers to our life in general. As we leave today, Pastor Debbie and I want you to know that we love you and appreciate you. So glad that you tuned in. Don't forget again that Mondays, Wednesdays, Fridays, and Saturdays, Facebook chats, and then Wednesday night and Sunday morning services that we'll have recorded for you. Amen. Today, I want to leave you with a wonderful prayer. I'm going to actually read it I can pray this and just pray it in my heart, but I want to read it from a different translation today. It's from Colossians 1. It's one of the, what we call the Pauline prayers. Amen. They're spirit-inspired, spirit-indicted prayers that we can pray for ourselves. And this just says it so well. I want to encourage us with this. These are the words of the Apostle Paul, and I pray for every person listening to today, that we're praying, asking on your behalf, that you would be filled with the knowledge of God's will and all wisdom and understanding in spiritual things, to walk worthily of the Lord, designed to please Him in everything, bearing fruit in every good work and growing in the knowledge of God, being strengthened in all power according to the might of His glory, patient and forbearing in everything, with joy, giving thanks to the Father, the one who equips us with adequate power for us to share in the inheritance in the saints in light, who rescued all of us from the authority of darkness and transferred us to the kingdom of His dear Son by His love, in whom we have the redemption, the forgiveness of our sins. Powerful. In Jesus' name, I call you blessed, and I'll talk to you soon.